Ooh, hold on. Okay, there we go. Hello. How's it going, everybody? Okay. So you may be wondering, what's going on here? Why do I look weird? Why does everything look weird? It's because I a fake mod. Yeah. So I was doing a big think. Well, first off. Let me minimize some tabs so I stuff stops freezing up. Okay. So, first off, how's everybody doing? Hope your week's been going well since we last saw each other. Yes, hello to Starman and Johnny. Happy to see y'all here. So yeah, how you guys doing? So since last stream I was doing a big think, and I was doing a big think, I was like, well, I remember hearing something along the lines of like, you should do like make content that you wanna see kind of thing, right? So like I was like I could do Plants vs. Zombies, or I just found out a way to stream my iPad onto my computer so I can actually show people how I draw. And I was like, you know what I really miss about like mid-2000s YouTube was like Pokemon Fusions. Like, Jaden Animations used to do them, and I was like, and when she stopped doing them, I was so sad. I was like, I want more of this in my life. I was like, I'm gonna do it. I'm not the best artist, but I'm gonna do it. Ooh, wait. Okay. Yeah. So that's what we're doing tonight. And then I was also gonna show some of the other drawings I've been up to, 'cause I having Dinah has been such a she's like my muse right now. She's like I just really like drawing her. Yeah, okay, I see chat, but I also saw that Amazon just dropped up a package, so I need to go pick that up just in case. So, BRB for like 30 seconds. The door is not very far, so 30 seconds. Okay, I have returned. Okay, sorry about that. Oh, hello, King. It's nice to see ya. Good to see you doing. How you doing? Okay. So you're slurping coffee, Johnny? Dang. It's one of those nights, isn't it? I am currently I've just been on a water thing. Like I've been doing so much talking today that I just need to hydrate a lot, so it's one of those days. It's definitely one of those days. And Starman, it's nice to see that you're doing a lot better. Let's see. Very intense BRB stare. Yeah, it's I have a really terrible setup, and like I usually draw in like the most awkward position possible, which is terrible for your back. But that's besides the point because that's what I do. Let's see. Okay. I'm experiencing some latency on my end, so if it's not affecting you guys, it's probably just something on my end. Yes, but am I going to be using Photoshop? No, so I hate using Adobe products these days because like I don't want to pay for a subscription. So instead I bought Procreate on my iPad. And I have the Apple Pencil too, so that helps. I was like, all right, it's like it's an investment, and I do use it, so I'm like, I'm pretty happy about that. is this an art stream or a Pokemon stream? It is a I wanted to draw a Pokemon Fusions stream, so we're gonna draw that, and I guess if you guys want to see what other Dyna fan art I've been making myself. I don't know if it's considered fan art at that point, but yes, okay, so because I was my point was because I like I draw in an awkward position, which is like almost 90-degree, like head down on my computer or on my iPad. I had to move my camera down to, instead of on top of my monitor, it's on the tabletop. But the problem is, like, the tracking is really bad, so like I look perpetually angry. And that might have something more to do with the lighting, but I look perpetually angry, but I promise I'm not angry with you guys. Are you well versed at making transparent backgrounds? I don't need transparent backgrounds with Procreate, because I can just turn off the background. It's pretty nice. Also, hello Electrolam, it's good to see you. How you doing? All right, so let's get this show on the road. So like I was like I have so my general idea here is we're just gonna take some random ass Pokemon, like I always do, and then you just shove them together, and then you we're gonna dr oh fuck, and then we're just gonna draw this. We're just gonna get this point. Now, okay, now that I say it though, I didn't think about how I'm supposed to get this onto my iPad, so I'm just gonna have to keep looking up and down and up and down and hope this works. I didn't I gotta admit, I did not think that think this through a whole ton. So let me just shove this behind me. Oh wait, hold on. Okay, there we go. Okay, so if there's alerts, they'll come out. And then let me. Oh fuck. No. Wait. Oh. Okay. I need this. And then we're. Oh. Oh no. 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 Okay. There we go. There we go. Letty bro, imagine the Twitter users rematching it to Loot Bro. Oh man, Twitter is like, I've talked to Noodle about this, but like Twitter is just too horny for my taste. I don't know how, like VTuber Twitter especially is like particularly horny, and I'm like, guys, stop it. Some of us don't need to see this when we're like scrolling through our Twitter timeline during the day. But I guess if like I guess VTubing is some people's job, so I guess that makes sense, but like I have a 9-to-5. I can't be seeing this on my Twitter timeline. Let me see if I can let me screenshot this and send this to myself. This is, don't mind my, I have the like the Jenga set up. I will literally just send this on my Google Drive to myself. Because that is the fastest way for me to get this file. But yeah, okay. So actually, let me. So while you guys are waiting, Pokemon. While you guys waiting, I can screw. Wait, where's my? Oh, there we go. Hold on. I can show you guys what I've been off. Oh wait, hold on. No, we need. And then we need. Oh wait. No, we want this on top of this. Haha! Yes. So I've been, ignore the fact that this looks like a meme more than anything. I've been doing a little doodles here and there of Dinah. Because I'm a narcissist, I guess. But yeah, I've been wanting. I was like, I have this terrible crutch. So I'm terrible. I can't draw without like basically bases and stuff, which is like really bad for my drawing, as a someone who wants to be a hobbyist artist. It's just hard. It's just hard, man. Hold up. I gotta go download this for my this picture for my Google Drive. This is the dumbest way to get files from point A to point B, I know. Okay. Okay, we're gonna save this image, and it's gonna go on my iPad. Oh gosh, okay. If Twitter's too horny, then there's a Twitter clone specifically for VTubers, and it's not that horny. Are you talking about VTubers.me? Because I joined that, and then like it's glitchy as hell. And then I saw recently that like it wasn't actually developed by the developer that says they developed it, and then the person that says they developed it is also like transphobic or something and like a liar. And I was like, oh. I wanna I'm gonna stay away from that with a 10-foot pole. Also it's like I don't know. The UI sucks. Let's see. Let's just do a screen size is fine. do you take Fakemon drawing requests? I sure, why not? I was gonna so like fully rendering these is gonna take a hot minute. So like I don't know if I can actually do that on stream. But potentially I can do like a vague sketch. We're gonna really test my abilities to like draw on the fly, and it's gonna stress me out, but here we go. But Tyner, can you give yourself a pink tuft of hair? I could give myself a pink tuft of hair. I've never considered that. Doodles of Dinah. I like that. I had originally thought up of like all the fan name stuff because I see people have those for VTubers. So like I have like on Twitter a like a fan art hashtag I think I made up. I thought about it way too hard, but I think it's literally like Dinah art, and it's like kind of dumb if we're being honest. Okay, so this boy has kind of like a. I should have gotten a different picture of Abra. This is fine. I think if we got this like roundish kind of looking face. I do adore like this hilariously like wait, let me make this a little bit more transparent. I like this hilarious like face, and then it goes eh, wait, hold on. It was like it's like bleh, and then bleh. He's like he's a strong boy. He's a little strong boy here. This is exactly what he is. you can't draw anything besides faces. That sounds rare. I have terrible anatomy. My anatomy is terrible. My rendering is terrible. Frankly, I'm not even sure how I managed to make this model look good. Like you can definitely see in the robe, I cannot draw a straight line for the life of me. It's technically straight in the textures, but it's like terribly done. I like in 3D. So 2D to 3D is not my thing either. nice drawing, but where's your power cord? Wait, I'm an AI. I don't have a power cord. Oh, wait, shoot. Oh, my bad. I'm dumb. I forgot to turn on my iPad. I'm so stupid. I'm sorry. You couldn't see what I was doing. But yes, strong boy. Look at this man. He's a little strong boy. what in the world? Instead of fusing Pokemon, we should fuse Dinah with Pokemon. That sounds a little Curse King, but if you can pull it off, I am here for that. Oh shoot, what is going on with this little boy? what's going on? Alright, we're gonna erase this. I have a request that would make a good test, I think. Yeah, go for it, Starman. I will do that. Actually, I think I have space. I could probably doodle it on this too, but like. Alright, this guy has no neck. You know, I'm not really good at drawing humanoids. Are things that are non-humanoid either, so I haven't actually honestly I didn't think this through. I was like, I just want to draw Pokemon fusions because I want more Pokemon fusions in the world. I didn't really think about the fact that I've never really drawn a Pokemon fusion. Like What is it? Like middle school, I found out from some other classmates that you can like recolor Pokemon, or like art. It's like selection or something. So you can do a specific kind of selection in paint, and I did that for a while. So I did like recolorings of like Pokemon. I think I might have done a fusion there, but that was like just pixel art. It was a wild time to be like young Dianna, because I was just exploring like digital tools. I was an avid reader as a kid. So digital tool kind of things wasn't really something I did. For a hot minute. Now that I think about it, if you draw something on stream, is it considered AI art? Should I post these on Twitter and tag it as AI art and see how many people I can make upset? I've low-key thought about that because I'm like, this whole I decided it was a poor choice in characterization, of to be an AI after I said I was an AI, and then I was like, well, shit, now everybody hates AI. So like I think I mentioned before, there was like this one time where I mentioned like in someone else's Twitter post that I was an AI and they never responded back, and I was like, shit, did they think I was actually an AI? Did I just lose a potential friend because of a poor choice in my character, in my lore? Have I goofed? I goofed real hard, apparently. Oh man. Okay, let me move the camera a tad bit there. wait, Swalot. Wait. So Starman, are you just suggesting I just do a Swalot? I don't know. I want a little goopy boy. I do like Swalot. He's a little funny boy. What am I doing here? Oh, my bad, actually. Hold on. This boy over here, he has a little. He's a little. A little. Oh, fuck. I'm also still trying to get used to Procreate. So, like, a lot of the time, I'll accidentally draw something when I'm not. Like, I'll, like, use my arm and, like, accidentally draw something, and I'm like, well, that's not helpful. We're all learning here. We're all learning here. And we got those little thingy going. Nothing wrong with pixel art. Yeah, I enjoy pixel art. I definitely have been coming around to it. I remember seeing a video on YouTube's about this guy who made this like really neat art piece on MS Paint. It's like, I think it's like friends camping out, and then they got a there's like a like a like a like a like an octopus kind of thing going on in like this this river, whatever this lake they're in, and then they're fighting it off, and like it looked real good, and I was like, all right, so this isn't like your 8-bit Mario anymore. We have, with modern technology, we have transcended, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, and non-binary figures, we have transcended Mario art, and we have gone into new realms. But that's not really something I've considered as myself, for myself, you know? Like, one of my favorite artists, Yume, I love her art so much, but I'm like, oh man, I can't get to that level. I can't get to that level. I need to level up more. I gotta level grind. So this is me level grinding. You can see from this little Letty Bra boy, I'm level grinding. Is this the prompt elementary school drawing of? Speaking of AI art, I have a grand request of you. Yes, share that, Starman. Oh wait. I think he has like, shoot, he has like some sort of. Oh, oops! I made the arms too short. We're gonna fix this. This is fine. He can have longer arms. He's allowed to have longer arms. Oh, look at his stubby little arms. Does fusing Gulpin and Swalot look like? I can quickly look at that. Because you can. Lucas, a gulpin. And then we're gonna do a swallow. Swallow. Let's see what this boy looks like. Surprise! It's just a purple gulpin. It's just a purple gulpin. I know these I just kind of picked the first one because I think this is the original Pokemon Fuser. I could be wrong, but I know there's like a few of them out there, so I just grabbed the first one I saw and I remember seeing people use, so I did it. For that matter, what is Bulbasaur and Venusaur fusion? Probably the same thing as the Gulpin. We're being honest. Oh, he has a little softer smile. I wonder if we can get that. Oops, I didn't want that to happen. Okay, so this is a hot doodly mess. But that's where the best art comes from what I'm told. Ooh, gouache. Okay, that whisker is not where it's supposed to be. That's okay. Okay, so we'll do that, and then I guess we'll switch pencils. Ooh, actually. No, we'll do this. Someone once said once had an AI draw a picture of based on the words Nixon, I'm not a cook. Is that in reference to some like actual political thing? I leave myself out of politics because it stresses me out too much right now, and I have no way of healthily expressing myself at the moment. So instead, I draw terrible Pokemon fan art. This isn't even gonna look right. What am I doing here with this boy? Oh, my boy! I'm gonna massacre my boy! What about Grimer Muck? He once said, I am not a crook. Ah! Aha! Aha ha ha! I should have taken AP US History, but I didn't, and instead I think I took some STEM class or what have you, that I hated. I think it was electricity. I was terrible at electricity. I am not a if it hasn't been made clear to you guys, I am not a engineer. Letty bro. You know, at some point I figure I'll get. Ooh, okay. So the fist is actually bigger. I figure at some point, like, I'll. I maybe it's just like an old thing, but like, do people do speed paints on YouTube anymore? I don't know. These days I just listen to a lot of video essays, because it's what I want. I would love to make video essays, but I'm like, man, I'm too tired. I don't want to do the research. Also, I don't know how to research outside of out of academia, because it's like, how do you even find credible resources that are that you could actually confirm that this is like a good thing, like it's not someone's like backyard thesis kind of thing. This is like actually proven and stuff. I'm like, I don't know, man. So I like listening to everyone else do it instead. Good boy. This boy is becoming something. Don't know what's going on here. Wait, I'm sorry, I shouldn't be laughing while I'm drawing. Oh boy, what's going on here? Oh wait. No, that's correct. We gotta. I've been talking to my coworkers about like getting better at drawing and stuff, and like it was very comforting to know a lot of the two coworkers that I think are good artists, they're like, no, we really need to improve X, Y, and Z. I'm like, wow, does that mean we can go on like an art drawing journey together? That would be cool and fantastic. I'm definitely feeling like the team I'm with right now, I'm like, this feels like a very positive a part of my life right now, because like a lot of us share similar hobbies. Obviously we do the same job. And like general, we're pretty friendly and stuff. And everyone's like very like very very like supportive of each other and stuff. So it's like, yeah. Non-toxic workplace. Who would have thought those exist? Oh, he's got little feet. He's got little like what are they? I want to call them like Mickey, like these like what are they called? Like Mickey like feet. It's just like if I imagined like you would make this in real life, it would just be like a little felt piece, you know? That's what I imagined it'd be. Okay, so about the Nixon thing, it says he once said I'm not a crook. So the resulting AI image was equal parts hilarious and blurry and gross. Delightful. I Okay, my crisis to refine this art based on my memory of it because I can't find the image of it anymore. I think I know what Nixon looks like, but now that I think about it, I might be thinking of Reagan. I mean, my very, I would it count as it? I think it will count as an AI image, if I draw this for you. So I totally, 100%. I will make it look like a beautiful doodle on a napkin. Okay, he has. Oh, interesting. Okay, so it's. I'm gonna do a little round boy, and then it's a little boop. Oh, baby. Okay, that's not gonna work. There we go. And then, okay, same thing. It's like, I'm also terrible at perspective. There's a lot of improvement, room for improvement here on the Dyna Twitch channel here. And I am here for that. This is how the AI overlords will overtake you, is that you're like, aw, they're so cute. They're like learning things. Oh, wait a second. Is that the nuclear the codes to the new what are they called? The nuclear launch codes? Where did they get that? Oh no, now they've taken over all of modern society. Who could have saw this happening? I guess that's, I suppose that's, unless some other, VTuber, oops, other VTuber, silly, like, I don't know, like aliens, or like there's like robots as well. I think the robots also want to take over. Depends on the sphere of YouTube you're on, or VTuber Twitter you're on. Where does this go? I think it goes like here. Oh wait, no, that's the wrong angle. We'll just follow. Actually, follow my sketch. A bit. Oh, you could go out and do plein air. Electro llama. I don't know what this is. I don't speak French. I'm sorry. What does this mean? Blah! Oh, he has little wings. He has his wings. Let me. Do I have a thinner brush? No. We'll try this. Let's see what this does. Yeah, sure, why not? We'll use that. Huh? Cool. Okay, we got some wing boys going on here. People mistake the two all the time. Really, Reagan and Nixon? Again, I don't know my AP US history, but like, were they even alive at the same time? Why do people get them mixed up? Okay, let's just. Oh, shoot. Okay. So. You know, if only my teachers could see me now. This is what I'm doing with my time, my degree. Drawing really bad Pokemon for views. This is a perfectly good use of my time. I'm here as an entertainer. Why not? Okay, I know how to defeat the new AI overlords. I just need to give them access to my browser history and they would certainly melt their brains. How bold of you to assume, King, that we didn't put in a fail-safe for people's weird search histories. Oh, that doesn't look weird. That doesn't look right. Oh man, perspective sucks. Oops, no, wrong pencil. Oops. By the way, if you guys are curious, this is a anime free brush thing that I found on the Procreate website or whatever the first link was. Seems to be pretty cool. I was using it last night on that thing I showed before. I don't know. I also don't really have a art style I'm like in love with, so that's why I think I've been experimenting with this like different pens and stuff, and it's really hard, I feel like, to know how to use a specific kind of brush digitally when you haven't used the medium physically. So like I was doing something yesterday and like I was trying to use the charcoals because I used charcoals when I was learning how to like figure draw and stuff, and I was like, it's maddening that like I can't make it do what I want it to do. But then like what is it like? I haven't really used like a whole lot of like other like I've used acrylics for painting, but like oil painting in the turpentine, I was like, I have no idea how to use these because it just feels so weird and like, why are you like not doing what I want you to do in my brain? Did I get everything? Yeah. Yeah, this looks exactly like that picture. All right, we're just gonna color pick this. Wait, I don't want to select this. I want to use this as reference. Oh man, this is turning out great. This is turning out even better than I could expect. Okay. So Procreate has this like really nice feature where if you make like a complete circle in one layer and then like you reference it and then you color drop into the next layer, then it just fills it in for you. So now he's like this fire engine red here, and I don't have to color it in, and then erase all the bad scribbles that I do, and then I don't know, I can do like shading or something. I think this is supposed to be, yeah. Oh, shoot. Okay, unless you don't make a complete circle, in which case now I have to draw it in. Basic color, yes. One time I had a dream the world was in an AI war. Oh man, I haven't had dreams about that. I've had dreams about being in Halo Reach, the Forge world, and I was being chased around by grunts. It's a weird dream. It's a really weird dream. Oh, that was actually red. Okay. This is fine. We can make his. We can make his. Oh wait, no. His whiskers are red. But the. Okay. So this is. This is. Okay. We're gonna go back to the other color first. This is fine. This is fine. Okay, so you could go out and do do plein air, and then it's when you draw outdoors. Wow. I don't know anything, apparently. I have done some of those. So like when in college, like I did like I guess what you would call like hard surface drawing. So like you would sit there and literally just draw like blocks or spheres that have like a bunch of light thrown on them, which is like weirdly relaxing, especially when it's like an 8 a.m. or like not an 8 a.m. like a 9 a.m. That my college was smart enough not to put any 8 a.m.s unless it was a test, because they knew college students were not waking up before 9. Right. Okay. I think this yellow is from the Ledian. Yes, a key. Okay, we got this, guys. So I that was like I've so I've had to do some drawings like that, or like perspective drawings. I've done it like out in the hall. I don't know. I remember one of my drawing assignments was like you have to go outside and like draw like a city skyline. But like nowhere on my college's campus was there like a place to get high up. So I had to do my best. I can't remember. I think I found some like it was like some like balcony patio kind of thing for one of our colleges, and I got a decent enough angle, but it wasn't great. Oopsies, am I on the wrong? I am on the wrong layer. How did that happen? I do. Okay. That's why I look all goofy. There we go. Okay, well now we're going back to this eye burning shade of red. But the AI was divided in your dream, Starman. Excuse me. Man. I feel like you're having more dreams about AIs than I do. What do I dream about? I don't dream about electric sheep, contrary to popular belief. I did see a cute picture though of like I think it was like Mikuhatsune, or like some robot, and it was like it had like a little Mareep, or like it was dreaming of little Mareep, and it was so cute. It was so cute. I love that meme. I can't remember which YouTuber put it on Twitter, but it's like me, my girlfriend, and her like $500 or like 4 foot life-size Mareep, and it's just him in bed, and his girlfriend is hugging this giant Mareep, and I'm like, yes, this is the content I signed up for. Okay, so one faction wanted to eliminate humanity while the other one wanted to preserve humanity and allied with them to fight the pro-destroy AI. Why does that feel like low-key, like an alternative plot to The Matrix? Like, am I wrong? I feel like. You know what? I usually do eyes on a different layer, so I'll do that on a different layer. Okay. This is. Boop. Nixon was president in the 70s and Reagan was in the 80s. Okay, so they technically were alive at the same time. And they were both old and conservative and from California. I feel like that's like. Man, I really don't understand U.S. history because I'm surprised to hear a conservative was voted from. Wait, I had another. Oh, hold on, there was supposed to be another layer for this. Okay, there we go. Like I don't know. Everyone says that California is always very democratic, but then I also hear it's like, oh, it's only the cities. But then it's like you only hear about the cities in California, so. Do the rest of California exist? Who knows? I kid, it does exist, probably. Probably. Okay. We're gonna throw the little gem color on to this one. This is fine. This is fine. Yes, this is fine. Once you're done with coloring it, make sure to post it on Twitter under the tag AI art. Yes, King. I will 200% do that. I don't. I'm not. La I don't want to say I'm labeling myself as an AI or like as a troll on Twitter. But at this point, I don't know how long Twitter's gonna last. Like, I actually did two tweets today, and then I noticed on the Discord that it didn't post, and then I remembered. Elon mentioned something about like after a certain date or whatever, like Twitter API doesn't work anymore, or like you'd have to pay for it. So like any integration, like Twitter integrations you might have might just break. And apparently that was today. And also like right now the Twitter logo is a doge, and I was like, it's not even an April Fool's thing at this point, because it's just like it's just like it's just there. And like, how long is it supposed to stay there? This isn't it's not April Fool's anymore. It's just April. Are you gonna keep Doge the entire month? I'm so confused. But yeah, there's that. I don't like the for you and the followers thing either, because it's basically the same for me, because I make it a point not to follow any like topics or anything, because like I don't know, it stresses me out. Like when I'm like scrolling through my Twitter, just like seeing what people I know are doing, and I'm like, wait, who is this? I don't know this person. Then I'm like, wait, no, I don't follow this person. Why is this being recommended to me? And it's like, I'm really great at making connections. You can tell. I'm a pro networker. So good at this. I had a dream about taking pictures of rainbows, and today Facebook showed me 8 years ago you took this picture of a rainbow. Does this mean that Twitter is actually all of our subconscious? This is what Twitter is. It's just our subconscious. Right. Okay. What am I doing? All right. So we got the base colors down, and now usually I throw them all into one little thingy, and I usually name it, but I'm not gonna name it because I'm too lazy right now. And now I'll do since we're doing a speed run of these outlines. I'm gonna oh oops I'll actually put in some shading while we're here. A loop. Oh wait, you know what would be even better? Wait, actually. No. Okay. Wait. I forgot to get rid of the extra little titty the little bits. There we go. Yeah, okay, this is fine. Where's my where'd it go? Oops. What's going on? Why isn't it? That's not the right color. That's why. Okay. Now we're good. Now we're good. Okay. Yeah, we can shade this boy in. Hopefully I understand enough of what I was doing to put in correct shadows. We'll see. This is fine. Okay. There we go. This is great. Yeah, this is almost every state. The city is more liberal in the suburbs and the rural. Yeah, and I kind of hate. I don't like I guess just for the chat to know, like I don't talk about politics a lot because I'm like I keep myself uninformed, so I don't really know what's going on, other than what I see in like the big headlines. But like generally, I'm like a little annoyed that I'm like, dang, it's really easy now these days to like play the politic game. Like you're like, all right, I know my fan base is like here, so I'm gonna go and like whatever campaign here instead of like, I don't know, campaigning for the entire people. Like it's like nothing is like a secret anymore. Like there is a very well-defined kind of like formula on how to win over certain like fan like areas and stuff, or like how to win over certain parts of the country. And it's like, man, it really kind of shows like how divided we are, and I'm like, I'm stressed out enough. I'm gonna go sit in a hole. Go scroll on Reddit and look at puppies or something. At some point though, I would like to be more politically active in like, I don't know. Not like, I don't know. Like one of my aunts does what does she do? She's like, I think she not campaigns, but she's like some part of some like group that's advocating or like a what are they called? Lobbying group, I guess, but she doesn't get paid. So it's not, maybe it's not a lobbying group. I don't know. But I was like, I kind of admire her. I'm like, wow. Like, she seems really happy. And I'm like, I can't not, you know, can't not knock it quite like that. I would like to be happy as well and be like, hey, I'm not just sitting here lumping a log that occasionally votes. Like, I'm actually going out and doing something with my life. Oopsies. I don't. Why does this look. Does this look like that, what is his name? Knuckles? From, like a really bad rendition of Knuckles from Sonic. But like he has like wings. Maybe it's just the coloration, but it's reminding me of that. We all used to have way more swing states than we do now. Yeah, and it like I'm like, it stresses me out too. I'm like, come on, like, it's like when I saw recently there was some bills passed in some states that are like, I don't agree with it. I was like, oh, this stresses me out even further. I'm like, I can't do anything to help these people that like don't want to be under those laws, kind of thing. And it's something I'm working on. I need to stop internalizing everybody else's like troubles and like, because it's not healthy. It's not healthy at all. So I laugh at my pain. Okay. And then, we're gonna do another layer, and it's gonna be for the wings, because I'm looking at the wings right now, and I really want to make a layer for them. A boop. There we go. Okay, let's go. Also, there's this like really nice thing where you can select it, and then like you only draw on that. So then I can go like, no, I can go like, and then so I get to get on the other parts of my drawing, and it's nice. Whoop. Ha. Save me time and money. Just like every other thing that gets advertised to me on YouTube. Oops. Okay. Oopsies. Oop. Okay. We're fine. We're gonna ignore that. That tiny little pixel there. Being liberal and conservative didn't used to be tied to being Democrat or Republican. Ooh, oh, okay. Okay, that makes a lot more sense. Yeah, because I always hear the phrase like something like ooh, my shading's wrong. Oh well. Yeah, I understand what's being said. Yeah. I mean, I've heard like I'm also not terribly fond of the two-party system, but like I have heard that like things don't really get done with multi-party systems either, so I'm like I'm not really sure what's the best route here other than just throwing away the entire system and starting over again. I don't think that's an option, but that's what I like to think about. I remember, what was it? I was reading this book. I can't remember what it's called. It was a book series, sorry. And it's like about this kid who like, so it's like America was like, guys, there's too many kids. You got to stop having kids. So they had like a two child rule, where it's very very like, yeah, only two kids kind of thing. And then this kid finds out that he's not the only one, and he makes a friend, and she's also like a third child, and she's like, I'm gonna go stand up for the rights of us third childs. Give me my color picker, please. Okay, there we go. And then eventually they make it, and then they tear down the government, and they're like, yeah, we're gonna need some time to rebuild, but we're gonna rebuild the whole government. And it was such a simplistic way of reformation of government. I was like, as a kid, I was like, yeah, anarchy. And then you read The Hunger Games, and you're like, oh, maybe this isn't as easy as you think it is. So I don't know where I was going with that. Oh, is that too big? What is this? Oh, that is too big. I The other thing I don't like about the two-party system is that, I'm not like 100% one way or the other, but it definitely feels like these days it's like you are either one way or the other way, or you're called a fence sitter or something, and it's like, oh, guys, you're stressing me out. I have enough stress in my life already. I didn't need you to be rude to me today. I'm not saying everybody does that, but it's like I definitely feel like oop, there we go. It's not okay to have mixed opinions, I suppose. Or like, I don't know, for a while I felt like the internet didn't, or like people didn't want you to be like, I don't have an opinion on this. So like I had I had a ex-partner who like would ask me about sports or something, and like if I had opinions on it, and I'm like, I don't have opinions on this because I don't do sports. Like, sports was his thing, but it was like do you like he's like, everybody has an opinion on everything, and I'm like, but I don't have an opinion on this. I just hear it, I'm like, huh, interesting. And then carry on with my life like a normal human being who doesn't have an opinion on something. And that stressed me out. There's a reason why I'm no longer with that person. But you're just like, not everybody has an opinion. I've been learning this myself. So like something very mundane or something, you could be like, hey, like, do you like what is something okay, something the East Coast, like, do you like Italian ice or water ice? And if you've never had water ice before, you can't give me an opinion. But then like in this case, the person would be like, well, you have to have an opinion, and you're like, that doesn't make any sense. I don't know how wait, I know some of you are from the East Coast. Y'all have y'all ever tried water ice? And have you heard a New Jersey slash Philadelphian person insist it's called water ice because they say water funny? Because I had this like great argument with one of my college friends about the Italian ice versus water ice versus like, I don't know, slushies or something, or like Slurpees. And I found a single article online, and the guy was like, "Hey, it was like some sort of like news, like I guess a jokey kind of like news report. It was like, hey, like, what's the difference between like water ice and Italian ice?" And then the guy replies, "It's like, oh, it's like water ice, like the flavor kind of sits on top of the ice or some nonsense." And I'm like, "That doesn't sound like science." Sir? But I think about that a lot. That lives in my brain rent-free. Because a lot of things live in my brain rent-free. Boop. Okay. Oh shit. Okay. I know I'm doing everything out of order because I forgot I should switch the background from white to like gray so I can actually see what has been filled in. And I know that's not white. Okay, you know what? I don't like that. We're gonna switch that to like a gray. Yeah, it's a little bit. It's like a blue. Yeah, this is like a blue white, then a yellow white. We'll go with this. 'Cause it matches better with everything else. Yeah, that looks better. Wait, fuck. Why didn't it fill? What? What color is this? What am I doing? What's going on here? No, this is the right color, so why doesn't. I'm confused. Okay, this is fine. We're just gonna color this in and carry on with our lives. The only point. At this point, the only thing keeping me from closing my Twitter accounts is Drill. I. Yeah, if I didn't want to network there, I wouldn't be keeping it. But also, I have a private Twitter account. And sometimes one of my friends posts really funny things that is very easily roastable, so I keep it for that. And then like my transit system, they also use they use Twitter. Actually, I should just erase this. They use Twitter to do updates for like the trains. because everyone uses Twitter. So I have to use that in order to make sure I know when my trains are coming. Otherwise, I might miss my train, or like I might get to the station early, or I'll be like, "What's going on?" And then I find out, "Oh, the train's delayed by 30 minutes. I might as well not go into work." Or maybe I can go get boba instead of waiting around here. Things like that. Which hilariously enough, so there's like Caltrain alerts. That's the system that I use to get to work. Am I in the wrong layer? No, I'm on the right layer. It's called Caltrain alerts, and it's usually not that great. And then there's better Caltrain alerts. And my favorite part of better Caltrain alerts is that like they'll be like, this train is off schedule slightly, or it's like kind of is slowly coming into the station. It's like very like, how do I phrase it? It's like very like millennial Gen Z, like non-assertive kind of language, and I think it's funny. Yes, how could you possibly not care about something I care about? What are you, a vegetable? Yes, I. That's exactly how I felt. I felt like weirdly stressed in that. And that, reflecting on that relationship, that was probably not the best relationship for me to be in. Less for like I'm not gonna shit on that partner. Like, we all have issues. But I was like, oh, this wasn't. We just weren't compatible, and you're like, oh man, I was just stressed out constantly, which is not what you're supposed to be in a relationship, unless it's like, I don't know, a neurotic dog or something. I would worry about my dog if he was constantly like stressed or something, which is another thing. I have my I was really worried when I got my first doggo, that she would be like afraid of like fireworks and stuff, but she didn't care. She did not give cares, and like since we don't go out on I'm a, my family's not very patriotic, so we don't really usually do anything for 4th of July, so she just kind of sits in her crate because she's like, no, you I don't want to interact with humans. She's so cute. I love her. Okay. I think I made his belly too fat, but that's okay. A boop. A boop. There we go. Okay, there we go. Yes. Waiting for the eye highlights. Very nice. Yes. Never heard the term water ice outside of a planetary s science. Yeah, I so here's the thing that makes me believe it is exactly the same thing as Italian ice, is because one of the most famous brands, Rita's, you'll find that on the East Coast. They are both like in like the Philadelphia, Jersey area, and then like I've seen them in back in my parents' home state of Ohio, and in New Jersey and Philadelphia, they call themselves Rita's Water Ice and like custard or something, whatever the other thing they sell. But in Ohio, they call themselves Rita's Italian Ice, and I'm like, no way do these people have two different recipes for two different parts of the US. I call bullshit. This is the exact same product. You cannot tell me otherwise. I will fight you, Jersey and Philadelphia, and I will win, unless you take out Gritty and the Philly Fanatic, in which case I might run. Okay. I don't think I accurately shaded this boy right. But he is my boy. And I love him. He's great. fuck. Here, his little whisker needs a little shadow. That. Okay, there we go. There we go. Look at him. He's great. He's great. He's great. I have just spent an hour doodling this boy. He's great. Sumo, Lady Brett. Yes, hold on. He needs his. Where's his title? We need to put a title next to him. Hold on. His name is. We're gonna. Oh man, this is a terrible writing. Oh, whew, okay. We're gonna find some other pen for this. Here, gel pen. That works. It's a. Oh gosh. Why does the. Okay. You know what? Whatever. We're gonna go with it. Ah. He's a sumo. He's a sumo lady, lady. hold on. It's Letty bruh. Letty bruh. Definitely legible. Well, so stupid. Yes, I will post this on Twitter. Hold on, hold on. Well, wait. I can't even remember what is my fan? I had this whole thing about my lore and nonsense. Yes, okay. My fan art is it's literally just Dyna art, but maybe we should just call it a Dyna doodle. That sounds better. That's kind of long, but whatever. Here we're gonna use a different pen. This one sucks. Cool. Hashtag Diner Doodle, and then we'll do a hashtag AI art. I wonder how many people I can make upset by just like hashtagging AI art. I'm genuinely curious to see if people will take it as a joke or like go off. I mean, like generally speaking, I'm like, yeah, AI art. The whole debate of it, whether it's actually art or not, I'm like, yeah. I'm still forming an opinion, let's say. I think that's a more accurate statement to what I've been thinking about it, because I'm like, I think AI art is a neat tool. But then at the end of the day, like, if you're gonna sell it and claim it as your own, it doesn't feel right. You know, because it's like, is that in the, no, it's not. It's not like your art, I guess. I mean, you did spend time. Excuse me. You did spend time, putting it all together. But like, whoop! Oh, I glitched it. I glitched it. All right. I just wanted to move. I just wanted to move. Oh no. Okay. We're gonna just move this whole boy up. Ta-da. Ta-ta-da. Oh, whoopsie. Okay. Oops. Hold on. Look at this boy. Hold on. And then, yes. Okay. There we go. Yes, we want this by cubic. That's what I just read. Yes, no pixelation here. I'm sorry. This is so jank. Where's this? Wait, where's this extra random bits coming from? Ah! This is fine. My goodness, I will fight you. I'll challenge you to a sumo match. Someday when I do when I do what the f what layer did I draw this on? Someday when I do oh, what the, wait, sorry, I'm getting distracted, but there's just this giant piece here that's, did I accidentally erase something? What's going on here? And I didn't duplicate anything. What did I do here? Oh, you know what? Is this in the wrong? That's why. Okay, so we gotta backtrack. So that's a I do this all the time. I constantly lose my layers. Yeah, I, oh, you know what? This is probably just a glitch. Hold on. Let me just backtrack what I was doing here. I'll just go back a few. Don't worry about it. Okay, there might be some, only so far I can go back, but we'll see. Oh, okay. I see what I did wrong. Okay. So what I did wrong was that I accidentally circled this awkwardly. We gotta circle the entire thing. And then I'm a goober. I'm such a goober. Okay, close enough. That's pretty centered, right? Yeah, there we go. We got this boy. We got this boy. He's a good boy. Yeah, we'll give him a little. Sure, that works. Bada bing, bada boom. Oh, the layers are backwards too. Oopsies. Oh. This goes on the top, thank you. Okay, there we go. There we go. The boy is done. But yeah, Starman, whenever I do I've thought like passively I wouldn't mind doing like playing games with viewers. It's just I haven't figured out a game and what to set up. But yes, I will fight you. Yeah, I think Electro Llama, I just accidentally circled it wrong so that like it like sliced out part of him and I was like, wait, that doesn't make any sense. Lore-wise, isn't Dinah an AI? Yes. Yes, indeed, I am an AI. I'm not a very good AI, apparently, because I can't keep up my own lore, but that's okay. Oh, I was putting words in your mouth when I was like, fight me, besides want to do co-op. Aw. Yeah, I love co-op games. I just haven't. I don't know why, actually. Noodle and I haven't really thought about doing co-op games. But, like, I like co-op games a lot. All right. So we got this boy. I'm gonna save this boy to my oh wait, nope, hold up. I'm gonna save him to my Google Drive and I'll post it on Twitter later tonight. All right. Is there any requests from y'all of what fusion I should do? Otherwise, I'm just gonna let it go random. Okay. Also, I hope you guys can hear the music, because I could have sworn I did this the tuning the leveling right. As long as it's background music, it doesn't matter. A boop. A boop. Okay, can we look at a Bulbasaur and a Venusaur? Ooh, okay, so we'll try that first, and then if that doesn't look interesting, we'll try your suggestion, Electro Llama. So we're gonna do. What are we doing? We're doing a Bulbasaur, a little Bulba boy, and we're gonna do a Venusaur. Yeah. All right. Let's see what this boy looks like. Oh He's so derpy. He's such an angry boy. I'm gonna save him. Look at this boy! Special needs Bulby. He looks like, I don't know, to be less special needs poor, this boy is planning our imminent demise, and we just don't know it yet. Like he's like a crocodile. All right. Let me try the gold pin. Gulpin, and then we'll do a random. Oh boy. A boop. Oh no, this is cursed too! He's so cursed! It's like, is this more less of a Pokemon, more of a how would I frame it? It's like a little minion. In like a video, like an RPG, like this is like one of those like dungeon crawlers that you would see, and he's like a level 5, so he's like a low tier, a low tier boy. Oh wait, oh yeah, you can swap it. Okay, so let's try swapping this, and then we'll try the other combination. Oh, this is even worse. I'm saving this, but this is even worse. So bad. All right. Let's do the Charmander. Charmander and then Charizard. Haha. All right, let's see what these boys look like. That His head's too big. His head's too big. Oh no. Now he doesn't have wings. No, now he's definitely not a dragon type. This poor boy. Looks like a Gulpin not got launched into a Starmie and splatted. Yes, that's an accurate description. Oh, that one actually looks close to Charmeleon. Oh, interesting. Yeah, you're kind of right. Oh yeah, you're like it's just like a big. Did you guys watch Dragon Tales? And then there was I think it was Lorca, the big like grandpa dragon, who told them stories. It's what it reminds me of. Just off-brand Lorca. All right, what was the other one? Staryu, Starvie. Wait, hold on, no. We did Charmander, Charizard, now we do Squirtle, Blastoise. And let's do a Squirtle. And then a Blastoise. I like how you guys are suggesting, like, first, second gen Pokemon. Like, none of the new stuff, none of the new stuff is good. Oh, it's like, Squirtoise. It looks like, how would you say? It's like a, you know how there's like, you know, when you go through puberty, so there's some kids that just definitely are like baby faced. This is it. This is just baby faced. This was just lazy, yeah. Oh yeah, the Dragon Tales theme lives rent free in my mind. I think I just watched a doc a video essay on it too, so it does live rent free in my mind for a little bit. Just a little bit. All right, so we'll do Pikachu and then Charizard. Pikachu, and then we'll do a yeah, can I spell that? Charizard, yes. No! Absolutely not, no! You know, if you thought the last one was lazy, this one is just super lazy. This is just so. I mean, it's kind of cute, actually. Maybe not. Definitely, this fusion doesn't look right on this website. But like, I think. I don't know. I think you could do it. Like a little dragon. Like a little dragon. How would I think of it? I hate it. This is not what I imagined at all. Oh, that's terrible. That's so bad. What did they do to my boy? Like, Pokemon Go right now has I guess it's because it's a Easter or like just maybe something theme, but their Pikachus right now have they have little like cherry blossoms on their head. It's so cute. And then you see this and you're like, this is not cute. This is not cute at all. Anything mixed with Charizard would be cursed. for sure. What ooh, hold on, music stopped. What team am I? I am which one am I? I am the blue team. Articuno. Blue team. Yes, Valorant? That's never mind. Valor. Or is that the yellow one? Mystic. Yes, Mystic. I dropped out of the po I got so upset when they switched Blanche's like character art. Like she used to be like a cool scientist gym leader girl. And then they made her like a little nerd and I'm like, I mean, you're still it just no, it's just saying it. It's just saying it. Valor's red, that's my team. Okay, nice. I saw a game theory about which team has the most, because I don't think Niantic published it, but like I think like game theory proved that blue team actually has the most players and yellow has the least. Purely based on people's favorite colors, because apparently people have like a lot of people's favorite color is blue. Charizard. Cool. Okay. That's true. Yeah. All right, wait, I think there was one more swap I wanted to look at before I settled on one. So let's do the Staryu, Starmie, which is, I could have sworn I've seen this one before, and it's literally just the same Pokemon, which is not particularly exciting. Yeah, it's just like a color swapped Staryu, and like if you, it's just gonna be a color swapped Starmie. It's true. Yeah. Okay. So I'm wondering. Okay. Let's. What if we just. Wait. Hold on. Let's. Do I have all the other gens? Ooh, let's do what was my I liked Empoleon. I didn't play Diamond and Pearl. I ended up playing Heart Gold, Soul Silver when that was out, and then I played a Black and White with a friend. So like, how cursed is this gonna be? He just has a beard. It's just an Empoleon with a beard. Oh no, that's terrible. This looks like a weird legendary, which reminds me. Do we have any legendaries? How do I look that up? Oh wow, they really oh, they got like a lot. Ooh, Dragapult's one of my favorite Pokemon because it's so funny. I miss what does it look like? Ooh, wait, hold up. Can I get out of this? Look at this boy. Question: are you ever gonna do Pokemon Nuzlocke challenge on stream? No. Well, maybe. Let me say maybe because Nuzlocke challenges, the ones I understand that exist are if Pokemon faint, you lose Pokemon, and I'm like, but what if I'm emotionally attached to my Pokemon? So short of it is I don't want to do Nuzlocke because I get emotionally attached to my Pokemon. that's literally it. I was thinking about like because I did like I think one stream of Violet, and then I ended up playing through it on like one of my I have a my Switch has a Mii account and a Dynamite account, and I ended up playing through the entirety of it on my Mii account. And I was like, do I want to replay? I don't know, I might, because then I can actually make good decisions. But then I was like, oh, level grinding? I don't know. Emotional damage, critical hit, yes. Wait. So we're gonna do Dragapult, and then we're gonna do something random. Let's see. I love Dragapult because it's just this silly little boy that has little babies of itself, and it shoots those little babies at its enemies, and it's like the cutest thing. Oh, and also this is pretty cursed. Do you want this coming? Oh wait. Hold on. It's like a spider. What is this? Ooh, no. No. Okay. So they don't have the no, latest gen. No, because like I think this latest gen, there's like this spider boy that's like human sized, and you're like, I don't wanna see that at night. But here we are. But let me. I feel like I could do a semi-cursed a Charizard Pikachu combo. And I have the pictures up on my in my wait. Oh, I always press the wrong button. Nope. Oh, what? No. Okay, wrong button. I still pressed the wrong button. Okay. We're gonna ignore the Noctipult boop and just throw the iPad right on top of it. Oh wait, no, I didn't download a picture of Charizard. One second. I fr oh wait. Oh, where am I? I need a picture of Charizard. Add to photos. Okay. Okay, all of that, and then we'll just. Okay. Okay. So we got. Oh, can I add all of these at once? Okay, no, it's not gonna let me. Okay, hold up. Okay, a bit. Okay, there we go. Here's my canvas, and then we'll add the photos. I love the old Pikachu because he's so round and so like fat. He's so cute. He's so cute. And then you look like a Charizard. Like Charizard is just this like angry dino boy, and then they had Pikachu, and then you're like, oh boy, there's like there's some inconsistencies here, guys, of like how you decided to draw your Pokemans. I think it's funny. It's definitely been interesting to see the evolution of like Pokemon through the years. Here we'll do we'll go back to that and I'll do sketch. Okay, cool. So we're running out of time here, so I need to do a I'm gonna do like a lazy like overlay drawing-ish thing, but not really. So like I think let me wait, hold on. Let's pull up the Pokemon fusion. So like I think for this it ended up having Pikachu, like the Pikachu ears on Charizard, which was kind of neat. Not this one. Oh, actually no, it was that one. Like the little ears is kind of neat. Charizard also kind of overweight. Yeah, a little overweight. Did we swap it? Yeah, nope, that's still cursed. We're gonna swap that again. Wait, no, yeah, we're gonna do that. Yeah, and we're gonna set this aside, and then we're gonna. Nope. Yeah, so like the little ears thing kind of got me thinking, because I was like, that's kind of cute. I love the Pikachu ears. They're so cute. They're so like cute and round. I should not focus just on the ears though. But yeah, we're gonna do a quick and dirty sketch going on thing here. And then like the face. Obviously that's a bad fusion, but I would probably keep the little Jawboy here. And then okay, so this is a 3D object, so we should treat it as such. And then he's a round boy. I feel like I want to make him rounder just because the old Pikachu was round, and I think it's funny to have a fat Charizard. Let's see if we can do it. He's gonna be a round boy. And he's gonna have little feeps. Little feets like Pikachu. Okay, so we're gonna and then I think I understand anatomy enough to do circles. Circles are your best friend when drawing. I think that was actually one thing I learned from my hard surface class was that you don't actually draw anything with like unless it's like actually like a square, like you don't draw it as like a straight line kind of thing. Speaking of chubby characters, I'm gonna paste a picture on Discord. Delightful, go for it. Okay. I don't know how to draw tails, so we're just gonna. Oh gosh. Okay, we're gonna do a tube, and then we're gonna leave it, and we'll fix it later. And then there's like fire and stuff. I also can't draw fire. He's kind of fat. Now he's. Oh, now I gotta move the face up if he's gonna be so round. A bit. So then we're gonna do this. Gonna make him an extra tall. Oh, now he's just. Okay, no. Wait. Maybe I don't wanna make him. Never mind. I scratched the making him longer. We're gonna make him like. Oops. We're gonna make him the same neck length, but then we're gonna make his neck chubbier. Because chubby Pikachu for the win. Now you may wonder, like, how does a Charizard like fly if it's so fat? And then my answer, I guess, would be to this imaginary question is that, well, Charizard shouldn't be able to fly in theory, but here we are. Oh boy, he has. Oh, I didn't even realize Charizard has only a, like he's a what do they call them? Like Terra, what's the scientific for try something tridactyl? Yeah, I think that's what I Game Theory did like a theory on Grogu. I think he called the Yoda species like a tridactyl or something because it has they have like three little claw things. Okay. And then the wings are roughly a triangle. And then. What do we want to do about that? I kind of want to make the tail instead of fire, actually, to be the Pikachu tail. And then we'll give him the little cheeks. We'll do the cheeks later. But yes, we wanna do the little triangle. And then. And then we'll do the little Pikachu tail because it's cute as hell. Where's that going? Out, and then out, and then out. Oh fuck. Shit. Where's this tail going? Eh. Okay, we'll get the signature look here, and then we'll backtrack from there. Eh. Okay, okay, we're gonna, Okay, this is a little bit chunkier than I was expecting, but that's okay. We'll figure it out. Alright, signature Pikachu tail. There we go. It's fine. It's a little shrimpy compared to the rest of the body, but we're gonna make deal. We're gonna make do. Post it in general. Yes, okay. Let me quickly see. I'm curious what you posted. Pizza has destroyed my life. I was just, gosh, I don't know why. I've been thinking about the Teenage Ninja Turtles a lot. Oh, no, it was because I was looking up something for work. Something to do with Microsoft, or not Microsoft, Excel, or whatever, Google Sheets. They had, like, my coworker was trying to figure out something to do with, like, selecting multiple things, or, like, selecting multiple options from, like, a drop-down. And, like, I was reading something online that was, like, yeah, I wanted my kid, like, my kid wanted to do some, like, whatever, stuff on, like, Excel or whatever to, like, about Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, but, like, Donatello couldn't select two favorite colors? Nah. So I made a thing that lets him select two favorite colors. And that's why I've been thinking about, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Okay. Okay. Oh, yes. And then he has the belly. We'll give him a belly. No, actually, we want... Okay, so we want to do that, and that. He's a big round boy. I guess the tail technically reaches past. Okay, we're gonna have to fudge this. Round, rotund. Okay, there we go. There we go. This is fine. This is fine. He's gonna have the round Pikachu eyes. Round Pikachu eyes. and then he's gonna have this the schnoot, a little schnoot, boop the schnoot. He's gotta have the Pikachu there. And then I feel like he's gonna end up looking more like a clown at this rate. What even is this? All right. Look at this boy. He is rotund. Okay. Detail. So I want him to have the little feet, the fingies. This is the wrong layer. The little fingies of Pikachu, and I don't really know how to execute that on a big hand. So we're just gonna give him these awkward little, like, dino hands. This is fine. And then he's gonna get the little feets. So he got a little a boop. Oh gosh. Okay, there we go. So I think it's this. Where's Noodle? Noodle should draw the feats. I think Noodle's asleep by now. Cause she's on the East Coast. Yes. Okay, so that goes behind, so I actually don't need that. Yes. Maybe Pikachu arms too. Oh, the Pikachu arms would be even better. You're right. Hold on. Okay, we're gonna Oh, wait, no. I just gotta rotate this. Huh? And then we could actually make this a little bit... Ta-da! Pikachu hands. I know this is I feel like the longer this stream went on, the more unhinged it became. So I hope you guys are enjoying this late night content. Here we go. He's th there we go. Yes, there we go. I know we joke a lot about Noodle not having a body, like the end of a body, but I noticed on her Twitch banner that technically there is a back to Noodle because it has little paws and little feet and like a little tail and little feet. So like Noodle technically has an end. Where that end is, nobody knows. Yeah, we're gonna go. Okay, we're gonna speed run. We're gonna speed run. Okay, so the Pikachu, it's a little brown on the bottom, so we'll go boop, boop, what even is this? Okay, so we wanna be able to see. He is so rotund. You gotta bend Noodle into pretzel to get to the end. Ah, yes. You know, that was something I really, it's a really weird thing, but I kind of miss Philadelphia for the soft pretzels, because like Wawa, you could get soft pretzels for like $1.50, $2 or something, and like that stuff was the best. I could eat that for like quote unquote a meal, which is definitely not good for you. But I loved it. It was fantastic. And like you don't get soft pretzels out here now, at least as far as I know. It just don't hit the same, man. It just ain't it. Oh man, I actually have to give structure to those wings now. We're gonna deal with the wings later. I don't know, I feel like the head needs to be more angular, so then like so then the ears stick out more prominently that they are indeed Pikachu ears. And then a little snout. Boop the snoot. He's got the little Pikachu, and then I think he needs to have more of a sh oh wait, no. I'm kind of just winging it at this point. I don't remember what Charizard looks like. Okay, there's the Pikachu. Yeah, there's those Pikachu eyes. There's a little Pikachu cheek. Okay. And then it's a little dupe. There we go. Okay. So the wings, I definitely simplified the shape a little too much. And I feel like we do need to make them a little bit bigger. So we're just gonna wing and generally guess how these boys look. I think they need the little thing. Oh. And then we're gonna go like this. Sure, we'll do that, and then that works. Then we do the inside of it. That should connect, I think, up to here. I don't think these wings could support a creature this size. Just gonna take a guess. Just oops. Just a guess. Curry wings kind of match Pikachu's style, though. You got a point. But this isn't just a Pikachu, like a fat Charizard, huh? Is it? I don't know. What works better? The wings are just for a mating ritual. Oh, it's like those birds with the like a peacock, because peacocks don't fly. Or no, some peacocks don't fly. I don't know. It just Oh, it does remind me actually more like a salamance though. Here, okay. We'll throw this away. Ooh. Okay, we'll do the round, boys. We'll be more round. All right. So what if we make? Oh, they're so round. How do I want to do this? I think wing. Oh, whoops! No, wings usually still have like a structure in them. So you gotta go like a boop, and then zoop. Yeah, close enough. This is fine. And then we got this, and then this, and then this. Wait, no, go back. We gotta that, and that, and that, and then go down. Where did I terminate these wings? Okay, they just terminate behind him. Okay, that's fine. Oop. Okay, cool. Okay. Okay, cool. I'm okay with the events that are currently unfolding currently. I am too. I am having a lot more fun with this than I expected because I was like, this is just derpy Pokemans. This is under the guise that I am learning how to draw art better, and I feel like I am. Every time you say this is fine. Do we need a I gotta set up. I think that it's really easy to set up on OBS, but like a counter. Like this is fine. Every time Dinah says this is fine, the counter goes up. And so you're thinking of the little dog in the burning house. What is the little dog in the burning house? All right, we're gonna do a lazy color in. Yep, we'll do that. I'll post it on Discord. Yes, thank you. I'm uncultured. I don't know things. Now the real question is, do we make him Pikachu colored or Charizard colored? What do you guys think? Is he worthy? Gold. All right. He's a gold boy. Yellow, orange. I could. Hold on. Let me think about this. I could. We could make him awkwardly color. Okay. Hold on. I don't know if enough about color theory to pull this off. Okay. We're gonna go with that yellow, orange. So like. Could also make him. Ooh, I wonder if I could do a gradient. Hold on. I think I have a madman crazy idea thing. Oops, that's too small. Okay. Again, lazy coloring. You do a gradient. We're gonna go a little ambitious here and do a great. Oopsies. Do a gradient. So like. This. Okay. So this. The absolute chaos. Oh, this isn't coloring it fast enough. I just want to color him it easily, and then. Bear with me, guys. I think I know what I'm doing. I think I know what I'm doing. And then the wings. Oh man, the wings. I didn't put any structure in. That's fine. We'll just do a lazy color in of that too. It's fine. Also posted me. Yes, thank you. It's very helpful when people post links into the Discord afterwards because I lose the chat after streaming and then I totally forget about it. I am very scatterbrained. Okay. So we got he's like macaroni and cheese, like fake macaroni and cheese, orange, right? And now we're gonna do a gradient on this boy. And again, I realize this is not like, this is the laziest coloring I've ever done. I just realized the original Charizard skipped arm day. Yo, if they don't go to the Charcific Valley, they're all skipping arm day. Remember that when that was a thing in Pokemon, Charcific Valley. I don't know who comes up with these translations, but they're very basic. He's a cheesy boy. He is a cheesy. Okay, the more and more I look at him, he is a cheesy boy. So anyway, okay, so gradient time. This is fine. Nope, that's too big. Now he's both colors. He's both shades of mac and cheese. Things are going to be a-okay, yes. Yes, this is fine. Alright, and then we'll be fancy. We'll add in a little bit of extra color in the wings to really bring it all home. Yeah, no, we'll just do this. Oh man, color theory is not my thing. I gotta get better at that. There's a whole list of things I'd like to get better at, but like generally speaking, I'm like I would like to get better at anatomy because I like drawing. Like whenever people draw fan art and stuff, I'm like, man, I wish I could do that. But then like, so I was talking with my coworkers about like, yeah, we're all bad at anatomy. We like to get better at it. And then like immediately after that conversation, I saw this post on Reddit that was like talking about like, infamous in the anime spheres. It's yaoi hands. Yaoi hands are like ginormous, and it's like, well. The opposite to that is shoujo legs, and I'm like, you're right. It's like Sailor Moon, like the original art, it's like their legs just go on for miles. Or like I was just watching Code Geass, and like their legs. I know Code Geass isn't technically shoujo, but like I think it's made by Clamp, who does a lot of shoujo. And like those legs for like high school students, those legs go on for miles. Okay, I used to fuse Pokemon to improve my fan art skills. That's not a terrible idea. Like for a while I was kind of ashamed of like my art because like you could see like I was doing like tracing, but like I don't know, like it's for me, like it's become more of a okay, so when I was younger, like I was always told like, tracing is bad, which it definitely is if you're trying to like pass it off as your own art. But for me, I've been using it to help with my anatomy, because like it's difficult getting like anatomy outside of like an actual class kind of thing, so and I haven't had time for that yet. But it kind of just helps me get the ideas down. And I've kind of just made peace with the fact I'm like, I like when I was younger, I'd have all these ideas, but like I wasn't able to execute it because I wasn't able to get it out of my head quick enough. So I'm like, well, so these days I'm just like, well, as long as I get it out of my head, and like it's like, and I make it very clear that like I'm not saying that I came up with everything here, like, and I'm just here for improvement, like, I don't care at this point. Like, I don't sell my art kind of thing, so I'm not, I feel like I'm more in the clear as well. But yeah, I don't know. I feel like early internet was not that great for my drawing prowess. Not comfortability. Yeah, I guess comfortability. Like, definitely made me really insecure about just drawing and things. So I didn't take any like art classes for the longest time because I was like, I feel ashamed kind of thing. Whereas like that's actually the opposite of what you should be doing. This is the jankest of quick draws, and I hope You guys are happy with this Chartu's face looks like a cartoon German shepherd. Well, thank you. Yeah, I'm proud of this boy. Oh, actually, hold on. Before I do that, oopsies. Okay, I already did that. No, give me. Yeah, I wanna put the little highlight in. I love the little eye highlights in anime art. Okay, let's do luminosity and see what happens. Oh, it didn't switch. Stay. There we go. A little bit. A little something something. Alright, and then we'll add on here the little eye highlight in Pikachu. This just got 10 times derpier. Look at this boy! He's so derpy! It doesn't help that it looks like he has a little blep. Because I didn't. Here. Less like a blep, but now I'm gonna give him a blep. Here, let me. Quickly. Let's give him a little blep. No, wait. I need to give him. Oh, it. Oh. He's blepping now. This is so silly. And then we'll color in his little tooth. Hold on. I think there's one last thing. I gotta get this shade of brown, and then, oh, this boy. Look at this boy. What is hold on. Okay. He's so derpy. And I love him. I think the wings should have black tips. Ooh, okay. Let's do that. Yeah, it's like referencing little Pikachu tips. It looks like he dug his head into a bag of Cheetos. You're right. This boy. Okay, he's got little wing tips. Or brown roots. Brown roots. Oh, I see what you're saying, Electro Llama. Now let me see what this looks like first. Oh. We could also give him brown roots, I think. Let me. And then we do. Kind of like the tail. Oh wait, no, that's not how the tail looks. No, that is how the tail looks. I'm not crazy. Yeah, it's like shoop. Hold on, can't do that. I like the black tips though. Yeah, I think I like that too. And then he has the. Oops. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna have to fill that in myself. Oh man. Okay. I know that. Here, I'll clean this up. Oh gosh. Okay. I'm not gonna clean that up because I made the bad. Actually, hold on. No. All right. I know I cannot do that. Okay. We'll just do this on a new layer. It's fine. Boop. There we go. And then we can fill that in. Cool. That looks good. And then we'll put that there. You know, let me do a little bit of a. Oh, let me blend it in a tad bit. That'll help. Maybe the. Nope, that looks worse. Never mind. I lied. We're not gonna blend that. He's so rotund. It's so derpy. He would not be able to survive. Look at this boy. He's beautiful. Okay. What a. Okay. Okay. So he is. What is this? He's a Charchu. He's a little bleppy Charchu. We're gonna use actual Charchu. Oh, it's actually Charchu, but we're not gonna pronounce the I. The I is silent. Thoroughly domesticated Pokemon. Yes. Can I select multiple? Okay, we're gonna just have to throw these all on. Can I? Nope. Okay. Yeah, they don't allow that. Cannot survive outside of captivity. Yes. Nothing survives out of captivity. All the Pokemon I make, they're just like horribly inbred creatures, created by man. You know what? Okay, this is not gonna work. Okay, we're gonna do the thing that I always do. We don't need that one. There we go. I'll move that in a second, but for this, I can move and make him bigger. Look at this boy. Oops. His name is Charchu. Oop, I'm gonna run out of space, aren't I? I'm terrible at, I'm terrible at space at figuring out space too. Here we go, boys. Boys and gals and non-binary figures. Get this boy. All right. I hope you guys had fun with this. I certainly did. Okay. I'll save that and we'll post it. But really quick, I was what do I want to show you guys? Not that you can't see all of my things, but so like this one, I did this based off of base that I found for free on tweeters. And I was thinking about making this an emote or something for like subscriber emote thing. You guys have already seen Cosmic Goddess Dinah, but I absolutely adore this one because I felt very inspired. Hugging a big hand. Yes. It's like a little chibi. It's like a little chibi Dinah. It's hugging like thank you for subscribing. And I just did pink fingernails because one of my nail polishes has like pink and it's I don't know. I'm not I yeah. Yeah. But yes. It's just a little hug. It's a little tiny hug, thank you. I thought it was a giant body hand body pillow. I've seen actually there are bases for characters on body pillows, but I was like that's a little too risque for my branding. Plus I don't know, I feel like I would make it into a gag, like all you it's just a computer. Like the pillow is just like it just has a computer on top of it cuz I don't know. But yeah, I do so like I do other doodles and stuff and like I don't know. Here we'll end on Charchu. I love Charchu. Oh, but yes. Thank you guys for being here. It was fun. I think I'm busy on Easter, but I wanted to start streaming on Sundays occasionally, like actually more frequently, but I haven't figured out how to. But yeah, so we'll figure that out. But also, we're at 40 followers, which is pretty neat. I don't know. I'll figure out the 10 other ones at some other point. But yeah, I appreciate everybody who follows me and watches me and hangs out. Yes, 10 to go. I'm excited. I'm excited because I want to be able to give back more to my viewers, but at the same time, I'm like, I haven't prepared anything. So maybe I should prepare things for when that actually happens because it seems to be creeping up on me a lot faster than I was expecting it. So you're like, oh, okay. Oh god, some viewers probably do have body pillow merch. They do. Electro Llama, I know for a fact they do. I think like the big ones that are made by that are, excuse me, produced by companies, they do. Noodle Cap body pillow would work though. Ooh, actually, okay, yeah, before we go, I'm working on it, but I have this like whenever Noodle and I do collabs, I wanted to have like art for us. And like, I want to do more fan art of Noodle because I think it's fun. But yes, body pillow Noodle. I'm gonna write that down. Body pillow Noodle. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Okay. But yes. Wrapping up things. Yes. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. It was really fun doing this. And I might do more of these when I'm like head empty, just want to draw kind of things. But I probably will turn my Thursday spot into like whatever I feel like doing that day, even though I really like Plants vs. Zombies. I'm like, well, what if I want to show you guys a Kermit rig? So that's what we'll do. So yeah, tune in next time. It was fun, guys. But yeah, I will see you guys probably next Tuesday to finish up, hopefully, Get in the Car, Loser. And then, yeah, whatever. We'll do something Thursday. But yeah, until next time, have a nice evening, everybody. Make sure to hydrate. Take care of yourselves, and I will see y'all next time.